Instead of creating a brand new Facebook business page, use the Facebook Migrate process. It's this free to use process made by Facebook for you to use. That way it turns your Facebook personal page into a business page. So if you have 500 friends, 1,000 friends, even 5,000 friends, the limit, you can migrate all of those people into a brand new business page and have all your friends now be instantly liking your page. Now you will still keep your personal page, but the new business page you get will come with some great benefits. And I'm gonna show you the process right now. And then at the very end, I'll go over all the reasons you need to do this process, the benefits of this process. If you already have a business page, then what you can do to solve for that, and some additional frequently asked questions about this process. So let's begin. So for today's example, we'll be using one of my good friends, Don, and we actually met at one of my previous employers when I was managing a marketing department for a mortgage bank. And so I worked with a lot of loan officers and realtors, helping them with their social media platforms. And at some point we managed like 90 plus accounts. So I'm just throwing that out there, let you know that I've done this many times before. So if you do have questions, make sure you leave a comment below so I can help you out. Dawn has about 600 friends on her personal page, and she also has a business page that only has about 200 likes on the business page. So we're going to migrate her personal page into a new business page, so she'll have two. And then in another video, we'll go over the merge process, which you will find very valuable too if you're also in this situation. So once we go to that website, facebook.com/pages/create/migrate, follow the prompts. There's four easy prompts, but let me walk you through each one because there are things that you need to know. If you're getting an error saying you cannot do the Facebook Migrate process, there are some restrictions or some things you need to meet. Maybe your account's too new, maybe you have some restrictions, maybe you just went on a friend adding spree and added like 5,000 friends and now you're trying to migrate your page. So there are some things that Facebook won't allow you to do because this has to happen naturally. So make sure that the personal page you're transferring is nothing like illegal, okay? Because they will block your account. So once you click on the Get Started button, you'll get to page category. Here you can pick up to three different categories that your business page will fall under. But remember that you can change these whenever you want once your page is set up. So if you can't determine three, that's okay. You can still set it up later. Then I'll click next and go over to the friends and followers section. Now when you get to friends and followers, it will automatically choose everybody that is your friend and that's also friend requested you or followed you. And I recommend just passing them all over to your business page because once you do that, they will get an announcement that you did that to encourage engagement. So it's a really, really effective tool to use. Now, once you've selected everything or just left it by default, then click next. And then you can go over to the videos and photos section. There's me and Don. But essentially here, it's going to ask you, what do you want to bring with you to your business page? Now, I've heard that if you start selecting things, the process to create the page once you finish will take long. I mean, like days. So what I recommend is don't select anything. Just don't transfer anything other than just your friend list and your followers and then create the page. Once the page is created, you can go back and download all your stuff that you want to take with you and then re-upload them. That way you get a little bit more familiar with reposting content, changing around some of the descriptions, or maybe even just going through some of the photos and deleting them. And then once you get to the very last section, the review section, you're essentially pretty much done. It's going to ask you, is this the business page that you want to create? Please approve it. And then once you click create page, then it will start creating your business page. And now you have a business page. Now you're not done yet because the page will still have to publish, and I highly recommend that you go through your page and start making all the modifications to the look of your page. Now this is the part where I have heard that people have gotten stuck on this process. And the reason why you could potentially get stuck on this process is A, it's technology. Things happen and sometimes things break. So if you are stuck on this page for days, then just delete the business page and restart all over again. That's the only recommendation that I can really give you, because if it's not working, it's not working, and it's technology. But you can redo this process over and over again. So don't worry about it, just delete the page and restart the process. And once that's like finalized, then you can actually click on publish your page, and then it will be live on Facebook for people from the community to start looking you up. And just also verify that everything has worked. So I'm gonna scroll down, make sure there's all her friends as likes, and there are. And now I know the process has completed. If the process did not work, then delete the page and create a new one. It has happened to me before. I don't know the answer to why it didn't work. It just didn't work. And so I just knew that I had to start all over. So delete the page and make it over again. Now, you don't need to have 5,000 friends. If you only have about 100 friends, 200 friends, highly recommend that you start adding people to your friends list. Just start going through your people that you might know and just click add, 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 add. Seriously, I know it might be hard to begin with, but let's be real, it's social media. We can all be friends online and keep it neutral. So you should be able to have more Facebook page likes, and you can do that by getting a lot more friends and then transferring them all over to a brand new business page. You know what I mean? Okay. Now, one thing that will not happen is your post from your personal page will not transfer over into your business page. This process will only migrate your friends list into likes for a new business page. That's the only thing that will transfer over. So no post. Your personal page will still be there. This does not delete your personal page. If you don't want a personal page and you just want to have a business page, you might just consider deleting all of your friends from your personal page and keeping a business page, because the business page does have to be administered by somebody, and that somebody is a personal page. So you have to have a connection to a personal page. That's essentially the only thing you can do, unless you create like a fake account with a fake email just for business admin purposes, and then that creates a personal page, and then you have that connected to your business page. But still, you're gonna need a personal page nonetheless to have a business page. Now, some of the reasons why people want to do this is because you want to be able to have the social proof from the very, very beginning. Imagine creating a brand new business page from the beginning and starting with zero. Starting to grow that is really, really hard. But if you've been using Facebook for X amount of years and you've acquired 1,000 friends, that's still somewhat part of your audience, part of your business. So you should be able to transfer them over through this process that Facebook has created for you, and allow you to give all that social proof from the very, very beginning, and then start utilizing that data, that proof, to then start growing your page to new people and let them know, hey, I'm not just a brand new business. I am a business with a reputation. Look at my profile. With all these likes, with all these great posts, with all this content for you to check out. So this process gives you that social proof that people start needing when they're trying to grow their business, AKA just more likes. And like I said before, it is highly recommended that you start adding your friends now, because if you don't have a lot of friends and you do this process, then you didn't move a lot of people. So I recommend that if you can get to 5,000 friends, do that. If you can't, just start adding more people that you might know slowly, 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 and then you might get to that point in a couple of months, in a year. But the more friends you add, the better this process will be for you, because you're transferring all of them into that business page. Another great thing about this process that I mentioned before is that it creates an announcement. It lets everybody know, hey, this person just created a new business and you have moved over with them. Let them know, congratulations, blah, 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 blah. But the great thing about this is that it's encouraging engagement. And from what we've seen from doing this over and over and over again on 80 different accounts is that when this notification happens, there's a lot of brand new engagements from people from friends list going on to the business page. So you're instantly already going to get a lot more viewers, a lot more eyeballs on your business when it opens. So that's the really great thing about using this process, is notification to that entire list. list of what you're currently doing versus creating a business page and then going through your entire friend list and being, please like my page, please like my page, please like my page. You know what I mean? Like, this process just moves them all over and says, he's started a new business and you like it. And if they don't like it, then they can just unlike the page. That is actually a thing that does happen. You'll see a few people like drop off from the page. Essentially what I'm trying to say is you're gonna get more likes from doing the merge process versus having to ask all your friends to like your page, because they're all gonna like them instantly versus only the few select people that really do like your page are going to like it, so. Now the answer you've been probably waiting for. I already have a business page. Now this is going to make a second business page for me. I don't need two, I just need one. Well, there is another process called the Facebook merge process. And the Facebook merge process is a great process. I've used it many times when I was managing a marketing department for a mortgage bank for 2 years, and I trained my entire team on how to do this process because it can sometimes get a little bit tricky. But essentially what you're doing is you're gonna be merging one business page with another business page together and combining them. Now there are some things to be aware about of this process that I wasn't aware about when I did it the first few times, so I'm sharing this valuable information with you. So please make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more videos just like this. But when you start considering the Facebook merge process, there are two things you really have to be aware about. Things that Facebook will put you through to go through the merge process can be a little time consuming. There's a lot of going back and forth with documentation, and I'll show you how to do that. But just keep in mind that I have merged two big accounts, one with a lot of reviews and a lot of likes, with a brand new account that just had a lot of likes, together and kept everything. So 5,000 plus 5,000 equals 10,000. You can do that, but you have to follow the process, and it can sometimes be a little challenging. But I will go over all of these in the Facebook merge video coming up. So if you have any questions about the Migrate process, feel free to leave your comments below and hit that like button and subscribe for more videos just like this. Or maybe you have some questions about a different process, because again, I've managed marketing for 2 years at a mortgage bank, focusing on social media, direct mail, email marketing, video, content creation, and the full thing. So whatever you need, let me know in the comments below and I'll consider making a video just for you.